Interpreting ability test results. Now, when people are using ability tests for the first time, the results and the reports can seem a little bit confusing, mostly because the scores are almost always norm referenced as opposed to simply saying how many questions the candidate got correct. And there are at least two good reasons for this. Firstly, say the candidate gets 12 out of 15 on a numerical reasoning test. Is that good? Is that bad? Unfortunately, we can't tell without some kind of external benchmark. Now, imagine we're looking at graduates and the average graduate gets 14 out of 15. It's a really easy test. That would mean the candidate didn't do particularly well. What if the average graduate gets 8 out of 15, in which case the candidate did quite well? Unfortunately, without that external benchmark, it's not possible to say whether the candidate's raw score, as we call it, is good, bad, or indifferent. The second reason is often with more advanced assessments, the difficulty of the assessment and of the questions also impacts the particular score. So with item-based assessments where different candidates get different combinations of questions, a candidate that gets 12 out of 15, maybe they were given particularly hard questions, which means they get a higher score than a candidate that got 13 questions correct, but given easier questions. As a result, we simply can't rely on the candidate's raw score, the number of questions they got correct, to inform selection decisions. It isn't ethical, it isn't effective. As a result, what we do is we use norm referenced scores. So when looking at the report of a candidate, what you will see is a percentile score is probably the most common way of this representing this information. What that means is if the candidate gets to the 50th percentile, it means they've scored exactly average for that population, whether it be graduates, professionals, managers, apprentices, it means they've scored exactly in the middle. So if it's a 15 question test and they get 12 out of 15 and the average graduate gets 12 out of 15, they're exactly 50th percentile. Now, if the candidate gets the 80th percentile, they're now in the top 20% of performers for that population. If they get the 20th percentile, it means they're at the bottom 20%. And there are other scores that we can provide, for example, STEN scores, which are a very simple 1 to 10 score, with 5 and 6 being average. We can get T scores, we can get Z scores, but they all represent the same piece of information, which is how well the candidate did compared to that chosen norm group, the relevant population that they belong.